Yeah, let's do Throne Out. So if you've seen seen my other band, Girls, Guns, and Glory, in a while, you've heard us play this one. There's a new one. It's going to be on the new album. If you pledge to help us out with making the record, thank you so much. We hit 102%, then they took away 350%, then we hit 101% today. So if you pledge, please give yourselves a round of applause. It's going a long way, so thank you guys so much for that.
Did you hit a tax code or something? What was that?
I don't know what happened. Somebody's credit card might have got declined, but that's my theory. But this song is going to be on there, and the truth of this song is I was writing and I was drinking organic wine that I picked up at Save More Liquors, and I should have known not to buy wine from Save More Liquors, but I got it home and I opened it up and it was bad from the start. And as I was writing the song, I was like, God, the wine looked bad, but I guess I'll keep drinking. And I was like, there's the song right there. I was like, that same situation's played out umpty nine times in probably everybody's life.
Was it or was it not in a box?
It was box wine.
It's the only place I've ever drank box wine is at Ward's house. It's actually pretty good, I gotta tell you.
I'm a connoisseur. The boat is the best of the box wine. This was some type of like organic. I can't remember what it was called. It was terrible. I'll never do it again. You know, fool me once, shame on you, organic wine. Fool me twice, to quote George Bush. It was something like that. The wine went bad, but I'm still drinking. Like I'll never get over my fascination with that place. It's like the craziest, like strangest, coolest place still around. Like my wife Crystal is here, and she and I we both kind of grew up summering up there, and then we went up a week or two ago. And we spending a weekend up there every summer is considered summering in this day and age.
They drove through it once in July.
Well, it's funny, you know, it's taken us years to figure out, but if you go to the Playland Arcade and you actually want to win anything, you just got to play skee ball. It's like the only way to get any tickets that amount to any reasonable value. So we, you know, we probably spent $30 playing skee ball, and we wound up with this like wooden sailor man that somebody must have made like overseas, and I'm sure it cost 30 cents, but it was really a point of pride to actually win that thing. And it's now displayed proudly amongst at least four or five other sailor men we've won at Hampton. But my dad did actually grow up in Hampton. He's here tonight, and you know, I'm not playing lonely. Having the family gets to see me in action. And there's a sign about old Hampton Beach there, the house that he grew up in on Nut Ave there near the you guys know the Ashworth Hotel. Right near that street. They tore it down, but screw them. This old house.
One, two, three.
This old house can stand for one more year. The foundation's caving in. The screens have all blown off. This old house could be a testament. We're going to do a song that I actually wrote this one maybe 6 or 7 years ago when I was living right here in Harvard Square. And my grand plan was I left the teaching world down the South Shore to move to Boston and pursue music. And, you know, I'd saved money and I just thought music was going to happen quicker and easier. And eventually what happened was we were playing like 3 gigs a month. I was like calling home to borrow money for rent and was really just kind of going broke living here in Harvard Square, having the time of my life. But, you know, music just wasn't taking off yet. And I also wasn't really writing because I was like so downtrodden with the whole thing. I was like, you know, I left the life I knew to move here, having to meet all new people and find my way. And I finally, one day, picked up the guitar. I shut off the soap operas long enough to write a song. And I was just thinking about John Henry and how much, you know, admiration I had for his work ethic. And, you know, I'm gonna ramble here for a minute, so please excuse this ramble. But for years, that story of John Henry had like just stayed in my head since I was a little kid. Of, you know, what is the meaning of his whole story, and why has it lived on in American folklore? You know, because it just didn't make sense to me. It didn't add up. I really thought it was so amazing that this guy gave everything he had and took on the machine, and he wins. And then in the end, he dies, and the machine replaces men working on the railroad and tunneling and laying track and all that. And I was like, it just doesn't make any sense. It's admirable, but it lacks the Hollywood ending that, being a baby of the 80s, I've come to expect. So, only a short time ago, I mean, mere months ago, I had the dog in the backyard, and you know, I guess just being me, I was thinking about the story of John Henry, and it finally occurred to me, I was like, that's it. Like, it doesn't need the ending, it doesn't need what I was looking for. Like, what his story is this man takes on essentially inevitable defeat, and in the face of defeat, triumphs with his victory and pays for it with his life. And I was like, that's the story of life. Of everyone here and everyone who will ever be born that lives to work a day, that's the story. In the face of our inevitable passing on, we fight. So
you're here.
It's beautiful. I mean, it's why that story has lived on. It took me 30 years to figure it out, but you know, at least I feel at this point I've drawn some meaning from what is truly an incredible story. And I'm eventually going to play a song in about 2 seconds, but you know, this song, when I wrote it, it was because I was a non-working person and admiring work ethic. And as I've now drawn more meaning from it, you know, I really am excited to get this song finally recorded. And it will be on the new album. And it only took 6 years to get there, but we're going to do it for you now. Called The Non-Working Man's Blues.
Channels turn like pages in a magazine. Make myself something to eat. Lie down, fall back asleep. It's hard to break this dead routine. Against yourself out of bed. Turn the TV back on instead. Think about all the ways to earn your wage. Use your muscle driving steel. Pay your debts and buy your meals. Doesn't seem that appealing.
Thank you. I'm not a working man's dude.